Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. This is lecture number 4 on discrete Fourier transform. In last lecture we discussed about the properties of discrete time Fourier transform. Now in this lecture we're going to see what is meant by the discrete Fourier transform. Myself Vikas Nitsa. So before going to start actual discrete Fourier transform, first we must know that what is the difference or what is the drawbacks are present in previous method. Basically, discrete time Fourier transform is also used for to find out the Fourier transform, and discrete Fourier transform is also used to find out the Fourier transform. Then what is the use of DTFT and what is the use of DFT? Both are using for Fourier transform. Then what is the drawback in previous method? That's why we refer discrete Fourier transform. That is the question. So the first point is the introduction. If you observe, the discrete time Fourier transform provides method to represent the discrete time signal in a frequency domain and to perform frequency analysis of a discrete time signal. Okay, so initially we are applying the Fourier, we are finding the Fourier transform for discrete time signal in a frequency domain. Okay, but what is the drawback in discrete time Fourier transform? The drawback is very simple. Frequency domain representation of a discrete time signal obtained using DTFT will be continuous function of omega to discrete function of omega. So what is the drawback? Initially we know that what is the formula of discrete time Fourier transform, that is x of e raised to j omega equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n into e raised to minus j omega n. So e raised to minus j omega n, in that case the omega is nothing but continuous function of omega. The basically the signal is discrete, but the frequency of that signal is nothing but continuous function of omega. So frequency is continuous. So in that case is difficult to apply or to perform a digital system. So that's why I have defined, so that frequency analysis of a discrete time signal can perform on a digital system. Means when if you make that particular continuous function of omega to discrete function of omega, if I sample that continuous function of omega into discrete, then and then only you can apply that particular signal or frequency to a digital system. So this is the actual drawback, that DTFT we can't use or we can't apply for the digital system, because the omega, the frequency in DTFT is a continuous. So in a discrete Fourier transform or in DFT, you can make that continuous function of omega into discrete function of omega. So if you want to make that discrete, you have to make sampling of that particular continuous function of omega, then and then only you will get discrete function of omega. So here I have defined that DFT of a discrete time signal is obtained by sampling DT of signal at uniform frequency interval, and the number of samples should be sufficient to avoid aliasing of frequency spectrum. So at the time of to convert that continuous function of omega to discrete function of omega, so this is only possible by using a sampling of continuous function of omega. So at the time of sampling, the one important point is nothing but that your sampling should be a sufficient or good to avoid aliasing effect. If your sampling is not good, then in that case your frequency aliasing will be take place. So let, for example, x of e raised to j omega be DTFT of discrete time signal x of n. So initially in DTFT, x of e raised to j omega is DTFT, and we are finding for x of n. Same way in DFT of x of n is obtained by sampling one period of DTFT, so that omega we have to sample for finite number of frequency points, because DTFT is nothing but for the infinite samples from minus infinity to plus infinity, and DFT is for finite number of frequency points. The frequency domain sampling is conventionally performed at n equally spaced frequency points in the period omega is greater than equal to 0 less than equal to 2 pi. The sampling frequency points are denoted as omega k, and they are given by, so this is nothing but sampling equation. So that frequency of DTFT e raised to j omega is sampled by omega k is equal to 2 pi k divided by n. N is nothing but number of samples. For the value of k is nothing but for k equal to 0 to up to n minus 1. So this depends upon, the sampling is depends upon the value of N, capital N. The DFT is a sequence consisting of N samples of DFT. Therefore, the sampling of x of e raised to j omega is mathematically expressed as, so this is your DFT x of k is equal to, this is a DTFT x of e raised to j omega, this omega is, we have replaced by 2 pi k divided by n. So this is nothing but sampling of frequency. So you, through this you can convert that continuous function of omega into discrete function of omega. Then the DFT sequence starts at k equal to 0 corresponding to omega equal to 0, but does not include k equal to n corresponding to omega equal to 2 pi. Since the samples at omega equal to 0 is same as the sample at omega equal to 2 pi, means for frequency equal to 0 and the frequency equal to 2 pi, for both case your sample becomes same. So generally the DFT is defined along with the number of samples and is called as an endpoint DFT, because in equations already we know that we define that is n. N is nothing but endpoint DFT. Your DFT or discrete Fourier transform is depends upon the number of samples. So here, first thing, definition of discrete Fourier transform. Here I have written wrong. So definition of discrete Fourier transform, that is DFT. X of n is nothing but discrete time signal of length L. X of k is nothing but DFT of x of n. Now the endpoint DFT of x of n, where n is greater than or equal to L, is defined as, so this is the equation for discrete Fourier transform, that is a, in place of x of e raised to j omega in DTFT, in DFT we have to write x of k equal to, in DTFT the limit is from minus infinity to infinity, but in DFT the limit is from n equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by n. In place of omega I have put 2 pi k divided by n, so I have taken sampling of the frequency. For k equal to, again the same case, from 0 to n minus 1, the value of k is depends upon the number of samples. So this is nothing but the formula for DFT or standard formula to DFT. Now if you want to find out the frequency spectrum using DFT, that already we know that, for if you want to find out magnitude spectrum, then magnitude of DFT, that is x of k, is equal to in root real square plus imaginary square. The magnitude of real square plus magnitude of imaginary square, this is nothing but magnitude spectrum. Phase is nothing but x of k is equal to tan inverse of imaginary divided by real, this is nothing but phase spectrum. So through this formula you can find out the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum for any discrete Fourier transform. Next, this is nothing but inverse discrete Fourier transform, that is IDFT. That is x of n is equal to 1 upon n, n is again nothing but number of samples. Summation is k equal to 0 to n minus 1, x of k, here is a positive j omega n. So in place of omega I have taken 2 pi k divided by n, again we have sampled that particular omega frequency. So for n equal to 0 to up to n minus 1. So is totally reverse of DFT. There is only one change, is 1 upon n is here. Okay. So through this formula, this is standard high DFT formula. So through this formula you can find out inverse discrete Fourier transform. So this is all about the discrete Fourier transform. In next lecture we're going to find out the different discrete Fourier transform for different examples, and inverse discrete Fourier transform for the different examples. So I hope you like this video. If you like, then subscribe and like my video and share my video. If you have any doubt about this difference between discrete time Fourier transform and discrete Fourier transform, then you can comment on my video. Thank you.